So I'll just send it back.
Right.
Well, Ben. Okay, what? Okay. Hair in a Crisis by Griffin's Beast. Lizzie was in need of a stylist and makeup artist muse. Where? First part of the vacation was in a hurry. She had to make a getaway quick to Mundania from Zenith. Hotel California, we can call it. Midtown, OKC. Welcome to Hotel California. Free shampoo, hot showers, food too. Not on our special diet, but hey, anything works. Lizzie was almost destitute at that point. Well, she did have a home, but it was a bit overcrowded. She had paths leading from one room to the other, a straight path from the front door to the back room. It was all covered with stuff from making Christmas cards and homemade presents for her rich relatives, because they always did homemade. Now, they said that Lizzie was once a school teacher. But you know, she talked to herself an awful lot into her car. You could see her talking and whispering, have I got this done? Have I got this done? What else do I have to do? Lesson plans, Christmas, cards, presents. She also sang to herself really, really loud and tended to be very interruptive in other people's conversations. And also, if you're a school teacher, especially if you're a substitute teacher, there comes a time when you're going to realize that that you are not as smart as a fifth grader. Now, sometimes you are as smart as a fifth grader, but that didn't come up. But those moments when you are not as smart as a fifth grader are the real embarrassing moments. So, a little stress. Okay. Hair in a crisis. Censor. Free shampoo. No conditioner. Not even the Suave special blonde shampoo and conditioner that she was used to. Her hair looked like twigs, or maybe like plastic snowflakes. They were still scattered on the floor. This is February. Maybe like plastic snowflakes all jumbled up together, sticking out and everywhere. And only it was like a sort of wire and nice orangey and white blonde. She had real dark roots. Well, she still has those. She wasn't exactly the snow queen. And you know, this winter, we were in need of a snow queen. State shampoo at the crisis center, it had something in it for critters. And that didn't help the situation. The maitre d' of this establishment, we can call the judge. He says, Lizzie, are you ready for the second part of this cruise down south to another port of call? That would be Griffin's, a fine hotel in the little central Oklahoma town of Norman. Lizzie says, yes, I am. She would do anything to escape those piles of Christmas card makings all over the floor, the dishes with dried food in them, the mold that was growing in her refrigerator, and making lesson plans comprehensible for middle school. If you're a teacher, you know middle school. Lizzie says, yes, I am, I'll go. No argument. Now, that part of the journey was by a special bus. One could look out all the windows and see the beautiful sunset featured in the flatter part of Norman, except for the grill in front of her. her. She couldn't see the sunset through that. That was a little distressing. Lizzie was tempted to count the windmills and telephone poles and the birds on the wire on the way down. By the way, Lizzie's real thing was PTSD. Her husband and daughter had died 20 years ago. She'd just been laid out of a cubicle 20 years ago, and she was just getting over that kind of grief. That's a hard situation, but PTSD strikes a lot of women, so Lizzie wasn't alone. The only thing she had in the way of makeup was a little bitty tube of petroleum jelly. Not the Pond's special she was used to. PTSD on a cruise can make one go without sleep, especially on a cruise that is actually a hospital. Lights on and off, crazy times of tonight. Okay, so she gets to Griffin's Hotel. Another client very kindly left Lizzie a little bitty tube of pink lipstick. Not the shocking red she was used to, but hey. Okay, so her hair sticks out about like this. Petroleum jelly sheen on her face and pink kissable lips. Also, lipstick for blush. Lizzie's parents came down every other day, but Lizzie's parents are old. And in addition, the Capitan, who was a very nice Oriental doctor, had to give a special order for makeup. So the first day Lizzie was down there, her parents brought down her makeup, but they had to take it back because she didn't have an order for it. The second day, they brought her makeup down. They brought it in glass bottles. Lizzie still couldn't have her makeup. Her hair was still sticking out like wires. The third time, her parents brought her makeup. And by the way, she had to shorten the list for her parents because they just couldn't. They were hard of hearing and they couldn't remember exactly what to be. So Lizzie says, just bring red lipstick and Pond's cold cream. The third time, the attendants on, let's see in Spanish, attendants, or French or something. The third time, when she finally got her makeup, it was time for her to leave that establishment. During her stay, after 4 days, her hair was, at first her hair was sticking, still sticking out dried and frizzy and like twigs, and Lizzie had to use the Body and Bath shampoo that was all purpose and kind of like the stuff they used in the car wash. The second day, Lizzie learned by observation that you had to ask the big burly deck master, shall we call him, behind the counter for a little green container of shampoo and a little blue container from the blue bottle. She learned this by observing. Nobody told her. So she finally got some shampoo and conditioner. That helped a little bit. Lizzie felt a little bit better. After all, they were dining out with men. The third day, another beautiful young client who reminded Lizzie of herself when she had first went to Griffin. Another beautiful young client told Lizzie to use the State Body Lotion on her hair. And that worked. That very day, she started out a conversation with a man. She had a sheen of petroleum jelly, pink kissable lips, and her hair was lying down. And she looked good. And she had a conversation with a man. The conversation kind of ended when the man says, you must be about 49. Lizzie laughingly said, well, no, I'm 62. And he left. She never saw him again. That's the end of my story.